I know if y'all had proof of me robbing somebody, we wouldn't even be talking. Y'all would have cuffed me. I would be charged with it. That's what I know.
The baby. This right here is Dababy, also known as Jonathan Kirk. For anyone who didn't know, Dababy is a famous artist. I'm pretty sure y'all heard his songs like Baby on Baby.
I'm going back.
Shug. Packing a man. Stuff like that. Gone. So back in January of 2020, Dababy was supposed to play at a nightclub in Miami. When they didn't give him the $20,000 up front, things started to get a little bit messy.
The tree blocking the view, so you really can't see much. It's his name is Dababy. I don't know if you've ever heard about him or not. Yeah, man. Yeah, bro.
And then when he hit me, everyone, all 10 of the guys who were in the truck jumped out, start telling me, shooting me across the street. Baby poured apple juice all over me, way in my pockets, took my phone. I was on the ground, trying to get up. He just poured apple juice all over me.
That's not professional business.
So in the surveillance footage, you can see that the tree kind of blocks out what's really going on. And you can even hear the guy saying that during the altercation, Dababy and 10 other guys in his entourage jumped him. The cops would even ask witnesses around the area. And while he was beaten up and on the ground, Dababy and his crew would rob him for his iPhone, his credit card, and around $80 in cash.
Allegedly, the victim saying that while he was on the ground, Dababy stole his iPhone and a credit card and poured an apple juice on him. There is video surveillance, but it's very hard. It's not good footage because
he would leave the scene and come back to the hotel a couple of hours later just to see the victim that he beat up and police officers waiting to arrest him. He was then escorted to the police station and told that he was only there as part of an investigation.
See, we just gotta do our investigation and that's it.
Investigation is looking at the camera seeing I ain't do a damn thing.
And in the upcoming clips that I'm about to show you, Dababy makes the detective look kind of dumb. He shows us exactly what we should do in situations like this, and he makes the detective lives a complete hell. Welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time on my channel, welcome. Today we're talking about Dababy's 200 play IQ on how he outsmarted the detectives and told him basically nothing. And I just want to say, if you guys are looking at things like this or have any sort of idea of jewelry that you would like, please check out this website known as Chew Chains. I'm partnering up with them and we're doing this long list of jewelry that we're giving away. And lately we've been receiving a lot of sales. So just because of that as a way of reward, we're actually doing 2 weeks of free jewelry. All you guys just have to do is pay for the shipping. So you can get stuff like this, a Naruto chain. I'm pretty sure they have a pistol chain, a car chain, the Cuban links chain, of course, then the bracelets, stuff like that. And we also have earrings. So if you guys like men's jewelry, please check out Chew Chains. I promise you it's fire. But anyways, let's get into the video.
My name is Detective Ledlow. Sitting in my robbery detective is Sergeant Murray of the robbery unit. And I just want to give some basic formalities out of the way, get some regular information for you, and then we're going to do robbery. What's your full name?
We just want to get it for you, man. This is just a formality. Just tell, you know, name, your date of birth, and all that stuff.
I've got formalities. I've got all that information. I know exactly who I am and my age. I know all that. I know that girl. I'm going to do all that. I'll just get to the point. Because every time we talk about the robbery and the bounty game, first touch. So come on. Let's get it over with.
Okay. All we're asking is for your name.
Yeah, ask me. I don't want to answer no questions. I already know the answer to, bro. Come on.
So you don't want to answer any questions, period, or are you?
Okay. I'm going to read you your rights, okay? I need you to acknowledge them as I read them. You have the right to remain silent. Do you understand that right? Mm-hmm. I need you to say yes. The reporter's not going to pick up.
Yes.
Okay. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. Do you understand that?
Absolutely.
Okay. You have the right to talk to a lawyer for advice before we ask you any questions. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
Okay. You have the right to have a lawyer present with you during questioning. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
If you cannot afford to hire a lawyer, one will be appointed to represent you before any questioning if you wish. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
You can decide at any time to exercise these rights and not answer any questions or make any statements. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
Okay, do you understand each of these rights as I explain them to you?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to check the yes box. Having these rights in mind, you wish to talk to us now?
Yeah.
Okay, do me a favor, sign right here on the X. Would you agree to speak to us?
So starting out, the detectives can already tell that this is not going to be an easy investigation for them. He starts off by refusing to answer a basic question like, what's your name? And he already got read his Miranda rights, so he knows that he doesn't have the need to tell them all the information that they're asking. He could just remain silent. And what's interesting is that Dababy is a millionaire. He has a lot of money. He doesn't even ask for like an attorney. And let's be honest, the best course of action when you're put in situations like this is one, stay silent and ask for a lawyer. But I think in this one, I think he's saying that he's going to take it on the chin and just handle the situation himself.
An incident occurred at the hotel, 1500 Southwest 1st Avenue, that you were there for, correct?
What incident?
An incident. You had an altercation with somebody?
No.
You didn't. Did you have a business dealing with somebody?
No.
You didn't?
No.
So somebody didn't bring you $20,000 in front of the hotel in your SUV?
No.
They didn't?
No.
Okay.
Somebody had somebody bring $20,000 that wasn't theirs and lied to them and told them that it was for an event of theirs on the 31st. And lied to them, that person, once he realized they were doing bad business, said nah and left with his $20,000.
Okay, so you didn't count?
And got my contact information to do business the right way. That's what happened. The people that got y'all put me in, because they the crooks. They the criminals, is what I'm telling you.
Okay, so you didn't count
$20,000?
Did you count $20,000 in
your
SUV?
No, I did.
Okay.
Yeah.
You did? Okay.
Around what time was this, sir?
I don't know. Whatever time they chose.
So you're saying that you weren't.
Whatever time the camera showed me not robbing no damn body that
okay.
time.
Well, were you there?
Was I where?
At the location where the $20,000 were being discussed.
I just told you they attempted to pay me $20,000 of somebody else's money, which I could have took. They tried to give it to me. Once I saw that it wasn't good business being done. What's going on? Y'all clear up what y'all got going on. They couldn't clear it up because they were doing bad business.
Okay, so
not only they was doing bad business from the get-go. And when the person caught on to them doing bad business, he got his money from them and he left. And he got the contact information to book me the correct way.
So right here is claiming that he has nothing to do with whatever happened to the promoter. The events are kind of unclear, but he's basically saying that his manager was talking to a promoter about performing at a Miami lounge known as Cafe Iguana Pines. And apparently the promoter didn't want to pay him the $20,000 up front, and he started to act a little bit strange. And this is where Dababy said he told him to get their act together and just left without an argument. But this doesn't explain the altercation that we see here on the video. But with the footage unclear because of the trees blocking it and no real witnesses except for the victim himself, if Dababy remains silent and plays his cards right, he could potentially get out of this free. A free man.
Okay, come on, bro. Do I look like I need to take anything from anybody? Come on, that's common sense. Common sense. You know what I made to even be down here? A promoter booked me at that hotel. I didn't pay to be at the hotel. It was paid for. You'd have let me on my room, you would have saw close to $250,000 cash legally, hard earned money. I don't got to take nothing from nobody, bro.
Well, let me ask you this.
I will go outside of here right now and throw $10,000 in the air. Like, I do not care about no money. I don't.
Bro. Was there an argument?
No, it was an argument. I didn't argue with a soul. And they argue with it. So, my voice was never raised. It was never aggressive language for me. None of that.
Was there a fight?
None of that. No, I ain't seen no fight. And nothing's taken. We shouldn't be in no robbery here, bro. So, when y'all get done doing what y'all doing, y'all need to do y'all job. Y'all need to follow y'all process. And y'all need to arrest whoever gave y'all these false allegations, bro. This is bullshit. This is bullshit, bro. This shit that cost me already $50,000. Already. All right, bro. Bullshit. This shit is bullshit, bro.
it might look like Dababy is flexing in these clips, but him bringing up these points that he's a successful rapper, he's making $30,000 off of one show, hundreds of thousands of dollars giving to people, hundreds of thousands of dollars in jewelry. These are actually all very good points in his case. We really got to think about it. If he's making all this money and he's on the Forbes list as he claims,
I'm on the fucking Forbes list, my nigga. The Forbes list.
Why would he need an iPhone 7 and $80 cash? Like, realistically.
That's fucked up. When we like, nah, what you mean? Put that dog on the floor. The bag, that stays here. But why you guys couldn't fly first class? I say, bitch, let us off in the next city. We fly in private.
The further he can place himself from this event, both literally and figuratively, the better for him. And so far, he basically denied that he did the crime. He had no motive to really do the crime. And he has a reasonable explanation for why he was even in that area. But to be honest, his car was at the crime scene. And the detectives both know that a crime did occur that day. They basically need to get information from Dababy to piece his day together so they can get information to form a story that he can't argue with, which basically will force him into a confession.
It is. This is bullshit.
Okay, where were you
at? Hey, calling my phone. I don't know where I was on Thursday. I'm not keeping track of where I'm at because I'm not out here living the wrong way, bro.
Okay, when I encountered you in the hotel, you came back to the concierge, the counter. Yep. Where were you coming from at that point?
Prime, street food.
Prime,
whatever the hell I went to eat, I went to get some food.
Where is that?
I don't remember.
You don't know?
No.
How'd you get there?
In the car.
What kind of car?
Was it
a car you drove, somebody else drove?
A Uber? Yeah.
What kind of car was it?
A Uber.
Small car, SUV, truck, what?
I don't know. Let's talk about what matters.
That's why we're here.
Talk about what y'all need to get me about this stuff. What I'm driving in, the car, what I went to go eat, what time I went, that don't have nothing to do with the fact I ain't robbed a damn soul. Me, nobody around me, ain't nobody robbing nobody.
Let's take the word robbery out of the picture.
So why are we here? Are we taking the word robbery out of the picture? Y'all are robbery detectives. This is robbery unit. That's the second word he said. That's the second word he said when he came in here, robbery. Come on, bro.
Okay, listen.
He told me, he asked a question to me about a robbery when I walked in my hotel. Robbery? I had every answer to the question you needed right there. Whoa, that ain't it. That's false.
Okay.
Throw that out the window. We talking about robbery, bro. It's nothing for me to talk about. I didn't rob.
So do you think that we just woke up this morning and decided to just...
I think y'all got a phone call from somebody that's already a liar. I know they're a liar. Got a phone call from somebody that's a liar and y'all bought it. Y'all believed it. Y'all got me in here. Y'all put me in handcuffs. Brought me outside the hotel in handcuffs. Cameras and shit all on me. Come on, bro. This shit is bad for what I got going on. And I ain't even do shit to that, man.
So even without a lawyer present, Dababy knows exactly what to do in these situations. And as of right now, he has the upper hand in the situation and he needs to keep it that way. The cops are trying to find anything that could place Dababy as a suspect, but by him redirecting the conversation away from that and putting it on something that's actually important, there's no way that the detective would get what they need. And it's still confusing as to why he doesn't just get a lawyer, because there is basically no harm in getting a lawyer in investigations like this. If anything, it would just benefit him. In the next couple clips, he would start destroying the detectives.
like we ain't two niggas that ain't never had shit. You got us fucked up.
Telling us that whole incident happened.
So
the whole point about this, we're talking about the same thing. We're talking about when
we talking about janky promoters, bro.
Okay.
That's what I'm talking about.
So you're telling me that whole incident happened.
We're talking about criminals. When I do business, it's legally binded. It's legally binded.
Okay.
Everything I do, you have to sign a contract. You got to sign a contract.
Okay,
it's
so
a contract
you're telling
right
me
now.
That whole incident happened and nothing went wrong. Nothing happened. There was no...
Not to my knowledge.
There was no fight. There was no scuffle. There was no...
I ain't fighting nobody. Bottom line.
Okay.
That should be high I am. I ain't fighting nobody. I ain't take nothing from nobody. Then the only two questions is that I should even be getting asked from.
So why would someone say that you did?
You got to bring him in here asking that.
bring him in here. But it don't matter. Regardless of what y'all got going on, see, this is why you do business the right way, which is not the way they was doing it. His name's on a contract, bro. So I'm gonna sue him anyway.
What was his name?
I'm gonna sue him anyways. Whoever y'all talking to, you tell me his name.
So who'd you sign a contract with?
Well, I don't sign the contracts. I'm the performer. I don't sign the contracts.
So your management team signs the contract?
Yes.
Who in your management team signed the contract with who? They don't tell you who you're performing
with? We don't sign the contracts. We draw them up. I just told you he signed the contract.
So who's he?
Y'all let me know, bro, when y'all done with the mind game questions, bro. I don't got time for
questions.
Whoever made the report.
There's no mic.
Whoever made the report. Whoever made the report, bro. Y'all don't got to act like y'all know less than what y'all know whoever made the report. But y'all know it's too much. Y'all know too many lies. You get what I'm saying? That's why y'all got to move backwards like that, bro. Like,
you're saying that they're lies, but you don't know what we have or don't have.
Okay. I know if y'all had proof of me robbing somebody, we wouldn't even be talking. Y'all would have cuffed me. I would be charged with it. That's what I know, bro. That's what I know.
While what he just said isn't true in every case, in this case, it's actually pretty true. If you would be in an interrogation room and the cops are trying to find the details of the case, instead of them just straight up charging you, it very likely means that they're missing some sort of evidence and they want you to give them that evidence or confession. The majority of the cases, detectives only interrogate suspects when they're missing or lacking some sort of evidence. So they basically interrogate suspects and use tricks on them just to extract a confession.
My side of the story is I ain't done that. I don't have a side to the story because I ain't done nothing to nobody.
Bro. So that's what I was
saying.
And before something could be done to me,
I realized I was dealing with bad business. And I
Why do you say it was bad business?
What?
Why do you say it was bad business?
I already told y'all that you want to wind this. You want to wind it, bro. I already told y'all, bro. My story not going to come out different no matter how many times I said it, bro. It's not, bro. It's right here. So you press stop and rewind and play, I'm going here. That's why I said it was bad business, bro. Come on, bro. This nigga blowing my phone up all day all night. He needed my help for his event. He already was in deep water because he's already doing, and I see why, he's already doing bad business. You see what I'm saying? He has an event that wasn't going to go as planned. He needed me to make up for that. He needed me to cover his ass, so he brought in another person, lied to him, swindled him. He thinking he coming to book me for a whole different event, and they tricking him, got him paying me to come do a walkthrough tonight. Come on, bro. You niggas full of shit. Ain't no point of me trying to help put on a wild goose hunt to see who that is. And matter of fact, check them cameras. Y'all got crime scene investigation unit out there. Check the cameras. See him meet up with somebody else in the lobby. Ask him, hey, who's that? Ask him. Follow up on what I'm telling y'all.
That's what we're trying to do.
At the end of the day, I would expect people to act on common sense anyway. Bottom line, y'all got plenty of sense. Y'all not stupid. Y'all the police, bro. I'm not. Do I look? Come on, bro. I don't know why I'm still talking, bro. I don't. So whatever y'all want to do, bro, come on. I got to go. So whatever y'all want to do, come on, let's do it.
What do you mean?
Let's do whatever y'all want to do. I don't even want to talk about this bullshit. I'm going to get this bullshit, bro.
For what?
We're not getting away, bro.
He basically told his side of the story and made it very clear that what he's saying will not be changing. So now the cops realize they're definitely not getting anything out of him. So just as they're trained to do, the detectives would leave the room and try to come up with another game plan to see if they can extract more information out of him. This is often done so a suspect can build up anxiety, which usually would lead to a confession. But in this case, he just fell asleep. Dababy's a different beast, man. He doesn't play. This is the man that killed someone in broad day in a Walmart. What can I say? And by the looks of it, apparently they didn't have anything to accuse him for. So the next time a detective actually entered the room, they just basically asked him about the security of his belongings that was left in his hotel room. And even though he hasn't been convicted yet, he was still the prime suspect of this investigation. So he'll be spending a little bit of time in jail as they try to figure out what to do and what type of evidence they can hold against him. And in this case, Dababy was looking at charges up to $10,000 fine, a battery charge, and up to 15 years in prison. And after 48 hours in jail, Dababy was then released and was just a free man. And around 2 months later, all charges were dropped and he remained a free man. Thank you guys for watching. Please like and subscribe. Remember, these chains are free for the next 2 weeks. If you guys want some free chains, just pay for shipping. Please click the link down in the description. And if you want to see a video about the guy that got shot in the eye and was still able to walk, talk, and be investigated by the police, click this video right here. I promise you it's a fire video. But anyways, goodbye.